아마 방송 많이 보시는 분들은 익숙하신 분들이실 것 같아요. 비정상회담에서 등장을 하셨던 분들입니다. 기욤 패트리님, 막심 소노시크, 조셉님께서 NFT 그리고 메타버스의 미래, 일상에서의 NFT라는 주제로 강연을 진행해 보도록 하겠습니다. 무대 위로 모시겠습니다. 뜨거운 박수 부탁드립니다.
헤이, that was really loud. So it's nice to see you guys here. We're so happy we have such a big audience. Thank you all so much for coming. We're so happy that you made it out. Today we're going to be talking about NFTs and NFTs that we'll see how they're not used just in blockchain or just in the metaverse, but across the whole spectrum of life. So we'll be having a discussion about that, and we'll be asking questions and kind of really trying to understand what NFTs will be doing as they move forward. So I guess my first thing is, if you guys could just both give a brief introduction of yourself and what you think about where NFTs are at today.
I think right now, every single corporation in the world is building an NFT strategy. Because the people who already started did so well that whether you're selling watches or art or anything that has value, everybody needs to build their NFT strategy to be competitive, especially the gaming companies, but not limited to.
Okay, just in my opinion, I'm gonna opposite you guys today, maybe. So NFTs is not like for everyone, because it's just on the initial step for now. So it's more like for business or people who just gonna, you know, kind of gamble money, maybe. Yeah, just like, or money washing. So maybe for now, it's not done yet, like the whole technology. It should be like developed more and more like in the future.
Yeah, NFTs are still pretty new. We've only seen the popularity of NFTs really grow in the last maybe 6 months. But they're being used for all sorts of use cases. Like you said, business. I noticed you have yours that's matching your watch. We have,
yes.
So there's a lot of ways that people can use NFTs to kind of not just like buy them, but express themselves, express like their self. I'm part of this community, or this is who I am, this is what I want to be. A lot of people have just seen NFTs as being something that is kind of, oh, I want to buy it and the price will go up. But what I'm actually seeing is, like you said, we're seeing so much more going on with NFTs. How do you guys see the NFT space then moving forward in the next 5 or 10 years, whether it's through business or through self-expression? What do you think will be some of the biggest or the most unexpected use cases of NFTs?
I think your passport will be an NFT in 10 years. So you will have your government issued ID, your passport, everything else. And when you vote in the election, you will be using that NFT to identify yourself. I think when you sign a contract for your apartment, that also will be on the blockchain. Everybody will be able to know how long you lived there, who lived there before you, and how much they paid for it. So it's going to be fully transparent, immutable.
That's pretty nuts. I think, like, when I come into Korea, I have to use my paper passport today, but thinking that I'll use something on the blockchain whenever I go around countries or I travel is pretty crazy. What do you think?
I actually totally agree with you guys, but I mean, I guess it's gonna be more like maybe in game industry than like in real life, because we also need to remember about like that not every country is really open to it, right? So for example, I'm from Russia. So in our country, it's pretty close. Like every technology is like, I mean, the government is opposite to all technologies, like all digital world. So like, that's why it's not as relevant for me personally, you know. But I think, yeah, game industry, like in gamification, like tokenization of all game assets, it's like, it's most, how to say, like most relevant stuff, which can happen to NFT in most 10 years, maybe, yeah. You can sell like your game assets, for example, or like, talk about metaverse, maybe you can sell some stuff from GTA like to Fortnite, from Fortnite to like Decentraland and blah, 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 like that.
Oh yeah, that's something that I think especially Korea is gonna be a place that can really lead, because Korea is already so interested in blockchain and gaming that it can really become a focal point of both where those two technologies can meet, where you can bring the whole gaming experience onto the blockchain and use it in a way where people can basically, you said trade assets and actually not just turn gaming from something that's just playing and enjoying into something that can almost create economic value and can have a real effect. And that's kind of my next question is, now we've talked about where NFTs will be and kind of how they'll be in the real world. Can you just kind of share a personal experience, something fun that you've done with NFTs, whether it's you've minted some personally or whether you've worked on NFT projects?
Can I start? So yeah, personally, I'm not buying any NFTs. I mean, unfortunately, maybe, but I'm minting NFTs. So since we're running like a lot of like blockchain companies, so yeah, I guess it's a good opportunity to monetize your business. Like, so you can be kind of ad-free, you can not have any sponsors, and you still can earn money from it. So this is really cool for like small businesses, for artists as well. But there is a problem with that. I mean, if you are not famous enough, I guess you can't do anything with that. So this is the main problem of NFT right now, because there is no way to, you know, push yourself in this world, like in this digital world. So yeah, but I mean, we just minted 5,000 NFTs last week and made it sold out on Zeta blockchain in 2 minutes.
Yeah, that's crazy.
That's amazing. Cool. Yeah. About 3 months ago, I started minting NFTs. And I was with a bunch of friends online, and we're just having the best times of our lives. It felt like we were 20 years younger, opening baseball cards, packs. And we don't know which one we're going to get. And we had such a great time that now everybody in my group chat, if you look at their phone, maybe you guys cannot see, but this is my favorite NFT. Does it show? Oh, yeah, it shows on the screen. And I love this guy just like I love my hockey cards when I was 20 years old. And it's such a great experience. It's hard to explain. You really have to experience it to feel how much fun and how much value NFTs have. Just listening to someone talk about it is just not enough. You have to try it.
Yeah, I definitely agree that, because even for me, I didn't start getting involved in the NFT space until probably 3 or 4 months ago as well. And I've been in crypto for 4 or 5 years. And even as a person who's native to crypto, watching the NFT space develop initially, I was also kind of...
I was skeptic. Right? I didn't get it.
And it sounds like you're still kind of like that. It's like, this is like pictures? Why would you buy art? What value is there to these kind of almost memes? Like, I can download a meme off the internet and enjoy it just like the person who's owning the NFT. I don't see any real extra value there. But as you get into it and as you buy your first NFT, you almost feel like you're joining a club. You feel like you're becoming part of something that's bigger than you. And I think that's especially relevant to Korea today, is Korea is really a new player stepping onto the global stage. Whether we see President Moon speaking at the new UN conferences, or we see BTS and other Korean contents, I think NFTs will be really relevant for helping Korea kind of take that next step and expanding the Korean community and the K-pop and K-games and even K-food and K-art into the world, and helping other people who aren't here physically still join that part of that community. So I think it's been really fun.
Yeah, you made a good point. Korean culture right now, because of BTS or Squid Game, is all over the world. But so far, Korean art by Korean artists has been limited to Korean buyers. But there's no reason why through NFTs the market for Korean artists should not be totally global, because once you put something on the blockchain, there's no borders anymore. So anybody in any country can decide to buy Korean art, and there's no issue of liquidity anymore. Someone in London can buy a Korean artist's art and sell it to someone in Canada, and it doesn't matter where they're from. So that's going to be a big win-win for Korean artists.
But I mean, then we meet like some money washing problem, you know, and we also could do it before, even without NFTs. So what can you say about it?
I didn't understand.
Like, I mean, we also could do it before, even without NFTs. So why we should choose NFT to buy in some art, for example? I don't see any value, you know, for art, actually. For collectibles right now, yeah, it's a thing. Really, if you're making like a game, like you know, basically it's a game. Like game or some collectible cards, like baseball, basketball, etc. So, but for art, I don't see any value.
Gio, I think you can share the story of the Korean artist who burned his painting and then turned it into an NFT. Do you remember that?
I can't understand what you're saying.
The Korean artist burned his painting?
Yes, this Korean artist from Hongik-daekyo, he burnt a painting, a real big painting that was worth a lot of money, and he put it on the internet, and then he made 300 NFTs with that painting, and he did really, really well. So that's just one crazy idea that people, artists, can use NFTs to sell their art. Really nice.
Yeah, and that's one thing that I've noticed is that initially I thought that NFTs would just be used for like memes or pictures or just little things that weren't that important. But literally every day, and I think OpenSea just talked about it as well, every day there's people who are finding new use cases and new fun ways to integrate NFTs into daily life. And we talked about like how maybe in 10 years they could be used as contracts, or even today they'll use as art. But I think one thing that we kind of sometimes miss is that NFTs are, there's always be something that we're missing, there'll always be something new. Even today, when I'll probably see a new kind of NFT and I'll still be skeptical. And because I think we're humans and we're not necessarily always open to new things, but we're going to see the technology progress and see how much easier it is than the current systems. Yeah. So can you guys talk about maybe what you think some of the advantages of using NFTs and blockchain over traditional finance or over traditional mechanisms might be?
Yeah. Right now, I can guarantee that when you buy a KakaoTalk emoticon and you pay 2,000 won for it, you don't really own it. It belongs to Kakao and you're allowed to send it to your friends. But once it becomes an NFT, it's truly yours and you can trade it, you can sell it, you can buy more. And if your limited series of emoticon, like the emojis, becomes really popular, then you bet it's gonna go up in value. And that's what NFT is all about. Ownership, scarcity. And once that idea gets applied to everything digital, it's gonna change everything.
Okay, I mean, talk to the ownership you just mentioned. So what I'm really excited about NFTs and what I really like, for example, in Georgia, they already are using like NFT contracts for real estate. Yeah, my friend just bought an apartment in Georgia, so yes, that's why.
Your friend bought a house with an real estate NFT.
Yes.
Oh my God.
So it's, I mean, it's pretty it's amazing. It's pretty easy,
it's
right?
Fast.
So you don't need
it's
any.
Easy?
Yeah, and you don't need any third part. You just bring your passport, go and buy your house, and they mint like your own NFT contract for your apartment, and then it's done.
Wow.
So it's pretty amazing. Yes, that's why I'm kind of excited about NFT, but I still have a lot of concerns as well.
Yeah, and I think it's natural to have concerns. I mean, just because this technology is great doesn't mean everyone who's using it is great. And there's definitely lots of scams and lots of weird things that are going on. So just because when we say we like NFTs, I don't think we're saying go buy any NFT you saw. I mean, even recently, you mentioned Squid Game. There was the Squid Game coin that in one day went from $2,300 to zero. So people definitely should be careful when they're looking at NFTs and when they're trying to buy them. When people are looking for NFTs, what are some things that you think they should do to both be careful and also on top of that, to find NFTs that are valuable or that really mean something instead of just something that's just that's like everything else?
I'm a terrible trader. I don't trade. I just buy what I like and I keep it. I'm not in it to make a quick buck, but you really got to be careful because some of those NFTs are really expensive and you don't know what it's going to be worth in 3 months. So just buy what you like. I don't want anybody to get hurt buying NFTs.
I mean, for me, just as I just mentioned, I'm not buying NFTs, but I recommend you guys to find some collectibles and try to hold it. It's good. For sure.
Yeah, I think that's something that obviously I agree. When you're getting into an NFT, I don't think your main purpose should be trying to be making money. It should be really to kind of either be part of a group or, like you said, use it as a utility, like to make getting a contract easier. But when you are buying an NFT, some things to look for, I think, are really to look at the artist, the person behind it. Because even though these things are digital, someone had to have made that and put it on the blockchain. And really looking at the credentials and trying to understand who those people are and what their values are and if their values align with yours. I think that's what's really important because that's what will mean if you're will help you, I guess, see that, oh, this is a community I want to be a part of. This is a group of people that I think align with myself. So I think you mentioned that you mentioned you're from Russia. How do you see things like NFTs maybe making life easier for people, whether it's helping them move assets like across borders or helping them just move things around?
I mean, how is it going to help?
Yeah, how do you think it'll make life easier in Russia?
For now, I mean, there is no way to help, but I mean, in the future, when we get like a metaverse maybe. So yeah, I guess NFT is just like a sound of technology for the future metaverse we're going to build soon. So for now, I mean, you have no way to use it for like exchanging some assets from a game to game. But I mean, in the future, it would be like the one way, I guess, like only one way to trade and move and share and whatever you want.
And also to Guillaume as well, what do you think are some things that, as someone who's international, you were in Canada for the last little while and you're now back in Korea, how do you think NFTs can make people who kind of are, for lack of a better term, digital nomads, or people who are wanting to, I guess, spread out and be kind of more all over? Do you think NFTs will have a role there?
I think the greatest thing about NFTs and blockchain really in general is that there's no borders. So whether you you want to sell your art to a local or someone in Canada, there's absolutely no difference. It's like sending an email, right? I can send you an email, you're next to me, or to my mom in Canada. It's the same thing. Well, NFT brings that kind of borderless experience to any transaction. It's not just limited to art. Right now, yes, people go on social media and they post their expensive NFTs and it's cool, they flex, as they say, but it's so much more than art. It's gonna be in a lot more in everything, and people will not even know that it's an NFT. They will just, the experience will be just seamless. Yeah.
Yeah, I think that's something that we have to remember is today a lot of us use things like KakaoTalk or Facebook Messenger, and we just think of them as like in the internet even as part of life. But for my grandparents, and I'm assuming yours, that my grandma still struggles using the internet. But I think we're going to get to an age where, like you said, once the front end and once the development gets really well, people will just not think of it as NFT even. They'll think of it as, this is my passport, just like we think of it today. I think that's going to be really helpful. Moving forward, I guess, into like the game space, and you mentioned the metaverse, what are some Zoom use cases today where you see people using NFTs to either like have fun or to kind of build their community outside of just the physical location they're at and bring people, a bigger group in?
In my mind, it's just like two or three projects, maybe Decentraland, Sandbox, Roblox. Yeah, basically it is.
Right now, until the metaverse is here, the most exciting things is, in my opinion, is minting NFTs. Minting NFTs is just so much fun. And you do it with your friends, and everybody does it, and then you just have such a good time that it's just worth every single dollar invested. And if you're lucky, maybe you get a rare NFT and...
I mean, it's fun when you have like million of dollars because it's expensive, you know, because of a gas fee.
But minting is a lot cheaper.
You can just mint it like that, bro.
Minting is a lot cheaper than buying on the secondary markets. So I like to mint.
Yeah,
I'm a minter.
And that's one thing I think that is really fun that people don't know. A lot of people, when they hear NFTs, they just go straight to the marketplaces like OpenSea or like Soul Art. But what, like you said, if you actually mint your NFT, there's some, like, it's even a deeper connection. It's I don't want to be too, you birthed it, like you really brought it into the world. It's yours.
Yeah. Well, there's the randomness of it, which is so exciting. And you just want to mint one more and one more, and maybe you get some NFT you really like, and you're just happy for the rest of the day. That's how it works.
Yeah, I guess maybe a good comparison. I've never bought a lottery ticket, but I think it might be similar to buying a lottery ticket. Like the fun of buying a lottery ticket is, like you said, that randomness. Am I going to win? Is it going to be fun? But the downside of a lottery ticket is the next week after the lottery numbers are announced, there's nothing left. That experience is gone. But like you said, with your NFT, if you mint those NFTs with your friends, and if you make it sort of an event that exists in the metaverse, that exists emotionally and really between you and the people that you did it with, you can come back, and I'm sure you still do it with your friends. You talk about those NFTs and you say, wow, wasn't that fun? Like, remember when we made these?
The NFTs that I minted will live longer than me. They will be still available for people to see on the internet way after I'm long gone. So in 100 years, 200 years, because they're on the blockchain, they're immutable and they're forever. So Yeah, they are my little babies, and they're going to outlive me.
I just wanted to argue, but you mentioned like after 40 years, it's okay. Yeah, now I agree.
Well, and you recently...
But I mean, now the main problem is a blockchain, right? We have a lot of different blockchains. So it's not like, interoperable?
Interconnectivity.
Yeah, so you have like Solana, you have Theta, you have Ethereum, you have BSC, Polygon. Lots of different blockchains, and it doesn't connect to each other. So how are you supposed to transfer this NFT from game to game, because it's all on different software, all on different base and stuff. So this is the main problem right now.
Yeah, that's true. One thing that blockchain, one technology that definitely it is developing, but they need to continue working on is interconnectivity and interoperability. Right now, most of that has to go through bridges, which are usually a centralized service that will kind of copy your token somewhere and print it somewhere else. I actually think there is a booth here today that is working on NFT interoperability, so you should definitely go check out their booth. But the technology will get there. I agree that it's kind of a 한계점? 뭐라고 하지? 한계? 영어로 뭐라고 하지? 한계? Like a barrier? It's a barrier that we'll have to overcome. But just like everything in blockchain, 10 years ago, people didn't think the scalability would be solved. People thought that Ethereum would never get off the ground, and I think look at where we are now.
Yeah, people sometimes forget that Bitcoin was 13 years ago invented, and the internet took a lot longer than that to get to go mainstream. The adoption of blockchain and Bitcoin, Ethereum, NFTs, is happening faster than the internet happened. So this is a bigger, more powerful movement that's going on. And we're just at the beginning of it. So yes, the Solana NFTs and the Ethereum NFTs, Ethereums are expensive. Solanas you cannot bridge them easily across, and it's expensive. But the technology is just being built right now. Eventually, you'll be able to use your NFTs in any metaverse that you choose, and it's going to be a simple experience, good user face. The user experience is going to be really good. You're not even going to anybody will be able to do it, even my mom.
Yeah, and so I think it'd be interesting, Maksim, if you can talk about what is like. From a business perspective, minting NFTs, what was that process like, and what went into it, and what were you guys thinking about when you were building the NFTs? From a business perspective, when you guys minted the NFTs with your business, what was that like to mint NFTs as a business?
Why we did it?
Yeah, what was your experience?
Talking about my experience in NFT. So basically, we're held in an online conference called Synopsys. So we just made a collaboration with one of our sponsors and partner called Zeta Token. So since they have their own drop platform, NFT market called Zeta Drop, we just decided to make a collaboration and made collectible cards to congratulation this event, and to just give it to our users and followers. So yeah, we just made a card. Actually, we've hired a designer, we made the card, it's pretty simple. Then you just mint it on blockchain you choose. So for us, it was Zeta blockchain, and then you mint. It's pretty simple, it's easy, and everyone like it, everyone enjoy it. So they just buying it and they can make money. So this is actually really important. So how you can make money on it. So when you mint it, you need to mint a lot of cards. We minted a lot of cards, and we also made some legendary cards. So when people who got legendary, they made around from 100x to 200x just in a few minutes. So that's what's amazing about NFT. And I don't think it's a bubble, because this kind of cards, it's only minted once, it's limited, and it's connected to some event. And I mean, it has real value. So yeah.
And to kind of touch on that, and I think this will be a good topic because we are nearing the end of our time, so we can talk about this the rest of the time. I think the real value that comes from blockchain is the fact that you know what's there is legitimate. It's like in the case of NFTs, it's that one NFT is yours and no one can copy it. Or even the case of a Bitcoin or an Ethereum, it's that Bitcoin is that Bitcoin, and it's not copyable anywhere else, and it's verified. With a lot of assets today, we have to either go through a bank or go through a government or go through someone else and trust someone else to do that. Why do you think that, why do you think decentralization, and as part of decentralization, the immutability of these tokens and coins is such an important aspect of bringing value to NFTs?
I think people are attracted to anything that's scarce. If you go to a room with 20 kids and you have 20 pens, 19 of them are blue, one of them is red. The kids are gonna fight over the one that's red. And if you change the color around, they will still gonna fight over the one that there's only one of. So everybody likes scarce asset. We like gold. Why do we like gold? There's other metals that are just as pretty, but gold is scarce. Diamonds are scarce. And NFTs, well, they're scarce. That's why I think we just like, it's like a basic instinct. Humans are drawn to scarce asset. And NFT is just the perfect asset.
It's perfect, but you need to be careful right now because it's still a bubble on the market. So yeah, when you're looking for NFT, just don't be kind of impulsive or like, you know, just try to look a real NFT with a real value. So it's really important right now.
I totally agree. I think when people are trying to find scarcity, like just because there's one of something doesn't mean it's necessarily scarce. It needs to be one of something that is cool, that's interesting. Like you said, like that red pen, it's because there's something, it's not just a pen, it's because it's the red pen that brings its value. And I think moving forward, blockchain is going to onboard those, not just NFT, like not just art NFTs, but like pictures, games, really everything. It'll make everything scarce and everything worth value. I think today, a lot of times when we're playing games or when we're doing something, I'll build a character. And even though I invested so much time and so much energy into this character and this game, it's, well, once I log out, he's not worth anything. But if I can turn that character and the things that character is holding it into an NFT and make it so that either other people can borrow that character, what they're using, or maybe when I'm logged out, I can say, here's my sword, I'll loan it to you, and you can do micropayments to me with Ether. I really think that the amount of value that we can extract, like basically everything we'll be able to extract value from because it'll be on the blockchain.
Yeah, eventually you'll be able to get a loan and your collateral will be your sword in Lineage or something like that. It's gonna be an NFT, it's gonna have value. And you need a $1,000 loan to go on a trip. You will be able to get it as with that kind of collateral. It's gonna be a totally different world.
Yeah, that's one thing I think a lot of people don't realize about crypto is that it's not just that you can make more money. It's not just the number go up. It's actually that you can then use the things that you're earning to, like you said, gain access to capital, to then either like move money more easily. There's so many use cases outside of number go up that I think a lot of people are missing. And I think really that's one thing that both people like myself and us that are in the crypto world need to do a better job of doing is saying like, hey, of course we love making money like no one, like everyone else, but this can really just improve your quality of life just by holding it even if number is the same. There's so many things you can do. So do you think there's anything outside of providing collateral or I guess number go up that we think NFTs will make life simpler or even just blockchain in general?
Well, NFTs will bring liquidity to any item that you want to tokenize. So I think in the future, if you just look at the things that you own, let's say this this microphone is probably very valuable, but if I don't have liquidity, it's going to be impossible for me to sell it. But if I put this microphone on the blockchain, obviously this microphone is a real thing, but the NFTs, if someone wants to buy it from anywhere in the world, then they can do so, and I just send them the microphone. And it's just maybe that was not the best example, but it just bring liquidity, so much liquidity, and so easy to buy and sell and trade, and that was not the case before. So a lot of that technology will be used for a lot more than art in the future.
Yeah, do you want to add to that?
I think I just agree.
I really think it unlocks the liquidity, and we're almost out of time. So to finish up, I mean, obviously this whole event is being ran in part by the city of Pusan. Do you guys have any ideas or any thoughts on how NFTs, and we already kind of talked about passports, do you have any other thoughts on how NFTs will help both governments and citizens kind of improve their relationship with each other and also just help the whole process of being a citizen in a country or being a part of some government organization?
I mean, that's what I just mentioned. Like, there are a lot of ways to connect government and people, like in normal people, civilians through a blockchain. Like I just mentioned in Georgia, right? But the main problem is that governments in many countries are not ready yet. So, I mean, I can just tell you a lot of ways, but it won't work. So this is the main problem we have right now, like all blockchain people around the world. So, but in many ways, actually, like you can just literally do everything through NFT, right? Like buying stuff, like ordering stuff, like selling stuff, so etc.
I think NFTs eventually will help every government around the world to have more transparent elections. Because
sorry, but we just done our election in Russia last year by using blockchain. It didn't work out, bro.
Properly.
It didn't work out.
I don't want to talk about Russian elections, but in general, you know, like in the, people are very divided right now, left and right, and they say the other side is cheating. But once the whole election process is on the blockchain, then you cannot say they're cheating. Everything is transparent for anybody to see, so you will know exactly who's winning. It will give also more options to the citizens who they can vote for. You can vote for like two people instead of just one, something like that. And no fraud, impossible to cheat the system. It's going to be fair and transparent.
Yeah, but for now I think it's kind of utopia, because they won't use like the existing blockchains. They're going to make their own blockchain, which is kind of centralized. So this is the main problem we are facing right now, is the government.
No, and I agree. I think the main thing will be that when blockchains and people like us and people like you guys here, we really extend our hand. And just like Puzan, when the hand of the government comes back and he says, we really want to make something happen together. And I really think that's kind of the core message of blockchain NFTs is, I want to work with you and you want to work with me, and I don't care where you're at, who you are, but we can do something together, whether you're in Canada, whether you're in Russia, whether you're in the United States or Korea. Blockchain can really help bring people together in a way that before was impossible, in a way that's trustless, that's decentralized, in a way that can really better things for everyone. So we're out of time. Do you guys have any last comments before we finish up?
NFT, we're just getting started. The metaverse, NFTs, everything is coming really fast. So if you own a company, you better get your NFT strategy started right now.
Just believe in NFT.
Thank you so much.
Sorry about the audio.